In the mid-1940s, Leonard Bernstein and his frequent collaborator and friend, choreographer Jerome Robbins, begin to think about how to reinvent, reimagine Shakespeare's Romeo and Juliet for the 20th century as a tale of violence and rivalry and love and hope. And as they begin to explore how to transform Romeo and Juliet for modern times, they imagine that this will be a story of Jewish and Catholic gang rivalry taking place on New York's Lower East Side at the convergence of Passover and Easter. And this Broadway production, The Great American Opera, is going to be called East Side Story. In our exhibition, we have a number of artifacts that relate to connect to how Bernstein and Robbins began to imagine this East Side Story. A music sequence outline, their copy of Romeo and Juliet, in which they note that this will be an out and out plea for racial tolerance, and they'll have a song called It's the Jews. And this imagining of East Side Story goes on for many years until they figure out that what they're really writing is a story of their parents' generation. It's not their story. The Jewish-Catholic gang rivalry of the Lower East Side it's been done. It's an early 20th century one. And they draw from the headlines of the 1950s and instead remake Romeo and Juliet as what we now know as West Side Story, pitting self-styled American jets against Puerto Rican sharks in a turf war set in as only it could be in New York City.